If consumers even know there's a DRM, what it is, and how it works, we've already failed.
What is DRM? Digital Restrictions Management. DRM is the practice of imposing technological restrictions on the control of what users can do on media. If you use Spotify, Netflix, and Xbox, PlayStation, Steam, Hulu, Amazon Prime, Amazon's Kindle, all of these are bundled with DRM, which prevents you from having control over the media that you downloaded and you probably paid for. I'll give you a good example. You buy all the books from Amazon, all paperback books, you store it in your library, and then one day Amazon enters your home, burns the whole library, and then just leaves. And then they say, we have DRM, so we can do that. That's how this works. Except that instead of physical books, it's ebooks served with DRM on Kindle. So you see, you never own these books. Back in the day, you could go to a store, buy a CD for the song you want to listen to, and then listen to the song, give it to your friend. Now you can't because you'd use DRM if you use Spotify or any of that sort. This is the future we live in. DRM is a failure by design. I'll tell you why. Let's say Spotify uses DRM to prevent users from copying the songs or recording it. Trying to censor anything digitally is going to fail. You can always have a microphone or camera pointing at the screen. In other words, DRM creates a damaged good. It prevents you from doing what would be possible without it. Let's say you have a book. There's no DRM. It's a physical book. There's value to the book, the paper, and the content the author has written. Now you buy the book for a certain amount and you can sell the book again to someone, your friend. You can lend it to your friend. They can make notes, they can copy it for reference, archive the book, keep it in a library, and it will be forever there with you. No one's going to take it away from you or censor the book once it's sold. So today Netflix can charge you $10 a month for HD content, and then in a month they say, let's send an update to all our users. Let's delete all of their HD copies, replace all of the movies that you downloaded, remove the HD copy, and give you a 480p version, and let's bump our prices from $10 to $20. How do they do this? Because they monitor and control our interaction with digital media via DRM. DRM is also a very huge security risk because this one small piece of code is running on literally every kind of machine and has control over the media and files running on the machine. It's better to support the artists directly without the intermediary taking a cut. I'll get into alternatives in a bit, but now let's talk about Apple. Apple doesn't like people repairing their own phones. And even if you take batteries or camera parts from one iPhone to the other iPhone, the exact same model, Apple doesn't like that, and it's not going to work. Even the App Store, there's no alternative App Store, and their operating system is completely proprietary. Apple can remove literally all of your apps or add more spyware, extract data from your phone. Apple, and not you, controls and owns what you can do on your phone. Again, proprietary software and DRM. Steam, Xbox, PlayStation, or any other proprietary platform all have bundled DRM. It prevents users from running single-player games if they aren't connected to the internet. How rude is that? Now, what are the alternatives? DRM, digital handcuffs. If you find a way to remove these handcuffs, your content is basically free and you have the freedom to copy it from one computer to another, just like the CD or the physical book. For content hosted on YouTube, you can copy the URL, open it in VLC Media Player, and then just save the file as a .mkv or .webm. Literally any song on Spotify or any of these proprietary streaming services, you can find it on YouTube. For movies, there's Odyssey and PureTube, as you're watching this right now. And Odyssey, which works on the library protocol, has support for music, songs, and some other stuff too. There's also Bandcamp, SoundCloud for music, and most of these things work with YouTube DL. I don't usually play games, but for PlayStation, Xbox, and Steam, there's GOG.com, which serves DRM-free games. But you aren't benefiting much because these games are already proprietary software anyway. For any kind of ebook, I suggest to get a physical book, that's much better, or get a PDF or DRM-free copy of the book. For app stores, there's F-Droid on Android. You can also install APKs, and there's Flatpak for GNU/Linux. As for hardware, it takes time. Research properly before buying a product and buy components which are easily replaceable. In this video today, I didn't address price. Price is a secondary issue. The primary issue, the goal of this video, is user freedom and to eliminate DRM. Media and files should be free from DRM, should be libre, and should respect your freedom. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Eliminate DRM, cancel your Netflix, Spotify, whatever. And follow me on freedom-respecting alternatives like Odyssey and PureTube. Stay safe. See you later.